Welcome to my channel. This is T's Thoughts, and I'm Teresa, and I talk about all things faith and books and lifestyle. On Mondays, you're going to get a dose of hope to encourage you for the week, and on Wednesdays, you're going to get book talk and some lifestyle videos. If this content is something that you are interested in, hit subscribe, hit the notification bell, and hit that like button, and share these videos with a friend. Okie dokie. So this week, I am going over my December recap, my book recap, and my January TBR. Okay? So, y'all, let me just tell you. November and December reading was pretty horrible. It was pretty, pretty horrible. I just could not concentrate. None of the books that I picked, I didn't finish. It was a hard read. Those 2 months were hard reading months for me. I think it was because of the holidays. I got really busy. I think the first part of November was good, but then closer to Thanksgiving, pretty much all of December was disastrous. I just could not think, and the books I chose were really good books. I put the link to my December TBR in the comments, but it was pretty, pretty bad. So I end up putting down mostly all of the books that I did. I'm gonna get them back because I think they were really good books. I just think that it was the wrong timing for me to try to pick them up. I was very distracted and trying to get focused on. My birthday was right after Thanksgiving, and I went out of town, and then Christmas was a whole thing for me, and so I just didn't do it, y'all. So I did find a book that we have a little free library at my job, and there was a book on the cart called The Country Guest House, but I think that's what it's called. Country Guest House by Robin Carr. Now that book was very light. It was easy. It was an easy read. And so I stuck with that and I finished it. And now I'm a fan because I didn't realize that Robin Carr was Virgin River from Netflix, Robin Carr. And so, yeah, so I picked up a couple of her, well, actually I'm gonna tell you about it because I'm picking up Virgin River book one in January for my January book. So now the holidays are over, I think I'm better. I think I'm in a better reading space, and I'm ready to get at it. Okay, so let's look at January TBR. Let's hope I can finish. No, I'm gonna finish these books. Okay, so January TBR. So one of my book goals, so let me tell you about my book goals for this year. I put it in my goals for 2022 video, but my plan is, so last year's book goal was 30 books. I didn't reach it. I'm going to talk about that in another video. But in this year, I'm planning to read 50 books. Okay. I'm planning to read 50 books. Part of my book goal is I listen to Currently Reading podcasts. And Meredith, one of the hosts up there, she loves Louise Penny. I read Louise Penny book called The Great Reckoning, and I really liked it. But I can't remember what number that is in the series, but it was it's pretty high up in the series. So I said, well, it'd be interesting for me to go back and read the series. And so with Meredith and Katie talking about it, I went back. And so anyway, I'm starting with long story short, I'm going to read the Three Pines series in this year. Okay. So I think it's like 10 or 12 books in it. So my first book for January is called Still Life by Louise Penny. This is book one in the Armand Gamesh series, okay? Well, the Three Pines series, if that's what you want to call it. So, and ironically, I had this book on my Kindle and probably over 2 years now, and I didn't realize that it was part of the series. So anyway, so I've just started reading it again. So anyway, Still Life by Louise Penny. This is the first book in the Three Pines series. And let me give you a little bit about it. Some of these words, of course, they're French because this book is based in Canada, Quebec. Chief Inspector Armand Gamache and his team of investigators are called into the scene of a suspicious death in a rural village south of Montreal. Jane Neal, a local fixture in the tiny hamlet of Three Pines just north of the U.S. border, has been found dead in the woods. The locals are certain it's a tragic hunting accident and nothing more. But Gamache smells something foul in these remote woods and is soon certain that Jane Neal died at the hands of someone much more sinister than a careless bow hunter. Still Life introduces not only engaging series hero Inspector Gamache, who commands his forces in this series with integrity and quiet courage, but also a winning and talented need of, so this is talking about Louise Penny. Anyway, so again, that's the first, Still Life is the first book in the series, so I'm excited about it. It's really good. Now, I've heard that it's slow, and it is a little slow. It's slower than A Great Reckoning, but I know it's the first book, it's building characters, because I think these characters are in the whole series, so I'm with it for the long haul. Okay, so far I'm enjoying it. I'm trying something new too, where I'm reading two books at once. We'll see how that goes. So the second book that I'm reading is Virgin River, book one. I don't know, I feel like doing series, so I'm gonna do series for a little bit. Virgin River, book one by Robin Carr. So if you are familiar with Virgin River is a Netflix show, and I like it. Sometimes people be giving it a hard time, but I like Virgin River. It's very cute, it's plain, it's simple, you know, but I like it. I like small town series and people knowing each other and neighborly with a little drama. I like it. So anyway, so this is a little bit about the book. It says this is the wanted sign. Wanted midwife, nurse practitioner in Virgin River, population 600, make a difference against a backdrop of towering California redwoods and crystal clear rivers, rent-free cabin included. When a recently widowed Melinda Moreau sees this ad, she quickly decides that the remote mountain town of Virgin River might be the perfect place to escape her heartache and to re-energize the nursing career she loves. But her high hopes are dashed within an hour of arriving. The cabin is a dump, the roads are treacherous, and a local doctor wants nothing to do with her. Realizing she's made a huge mistake, Mel decides to leave town the following morning. But a tiny baby abandoned on a front porch changes her plans, and former Marine Jack Sheridan cements them into place. Okay. Now, I watched episode number one. I don't remember the baby, but I might have to go back and look at that. But anyway, so I think it's going to be cute. If I read a book, I normally don't watch the TV or the movie adaptation because it always don't live up to the book to me and how I created the characters in my mind. But since I saw the series and I kind of like Robin Carr, I think I'm gonna enjoy these. So that's book number two. Book number three is, now those two I'm reading on my Kindle, okay? Book number three is The Joy of Less, A Minimalist Guide to Decluttering. This book, let's see if I can't get it into frame. I think you can see it. Okay, so this book is a part of my Organize You book club, okay? I talked about Organize You and my 2022 goals. I am trying to get my life together and getting some order in my life, some organization in my life. So this is our January book for the Organize You membership club that I'm in. And so it is, so far so good, it's pretty good. It's talking about a minimalist guide to declutter, organize, and simplify. Try to be, declutter every area of your home, of your life. And being more minimal than having so much stuff. Ugh. Okay. So I'm enjoying that. And I'm ready to get into that because I started it. Actually, y'all, I'm reading three books at once. I'm probably overcompensating for November and December. But it's okay. It's okay. We got it. We got it going on. So, that's book number three. Okay. So if you like minimalists, if you try to get organization, if you're trying to declutter your home, declutter all the things, because I think if you declutter the things around you, your mind would be a little bit better. You have some, not so much to think about. Okay. So, if that's interesting to you, I'll leave the link in the description box below. Okay. So, and lastly, this is another book that I got from the Organize You, and it's called The 5 Money Personalities by Scott and Bethany Palmer. This is a married couple, and they are talking about healthy relationships when it comes to money. How couples we all have money personalities, and if we understand those personalities, then we'll be able to better communicate with our spouse or a partner in order to have good, healthy relationships when it comes to money. Money is a probably about the number one, besides infidelity, reasons for divorce in families, in marriages, because of we don't understand each other's money personalities and how we can work together in order to still be able to manage our money together. And I know for me and my husband, when we first got married, we had different personalities. We still do have different personalities. I'll spend a dollar right now, whereas he'll hold it, and I'll be like, "Babe, can we get this new bed? 'Cause we need one." And he'd be like, "Let me think, let me think." And it's 3 weeks later, and I would have been and bought it. But that's how he is, and so I have to wait. And he's a thinker. He thinks about the spending, and I save, and I'm learning better to save my money. So anyway, that's a whole nother thing. I may start doing some budget videos. That's part of my lifestyle for now. Anywho, so. That's part of the 5 Money Personalities by Scott and Bethany Palmer. So those are my four books for this month. Two fiction, two nonfiction, and I don't know if I'm gonna put this in my TBR. No, I'm not gonna put that in my TBR because I am doing one Christian book that I am teaching from for our women's group. So that's a whole nother thing. Anyway, if you have read any of these books, let me know in the comment box. Let me know if you've read these books, Still Life, Virgin River. Tell me what are your thoughts on Virgin River? I'll be really interested to see if I don't think I'm the minority on this one, but we'll see. So I don't think so, because I don't think it would have been a Netflix series if people didn't like it. So anyway, if you've read these books or if you have any book suggestions for me, let me know in the comments, okay? All right, guys. You guys, if you enjoyed this video, like it, share it with a friend. If you're not already subscribed, subscribe, hit that notification bell, and I will see you next week. All right? Again, be kind to yourself. Don't you forget to be kind to yourself. Be kind to yourself. Be kind to someone else, and have a grace-filled week. I'll see you next week. Bye.